those who believe in the finality of death, in other words, that there is no afterlife, they are the ones who advocate suicide and regard it as a matter of personal choice. On the other hand, those who firmly believe in some form of existence after corporeal death, they are the ones who condemn suicide and judge it to be a major sin. Yet, rationally, the situation should have been reversed. It should have been easier for someone who believed in continuity after death to terminate this phase of existence on the way to the next. Those who faced void, finality, non-existence, vanishing, they should have been greatly deterred by suicide and should have refrained even from entertaining the idea. Either the latter do not really believe what they profess to believe, or something is wrong with rationality. One would tend to suspect the former.